Hi, I'm Daniel Weisberg, search advocate at Google. And in this video, I'll discuss how to quickly uncover reasons if you find a drop in your Google search traffic. Then, I'll share some tips on how to analyze a drop using the Search Console Performance Report and Google Trends. As I discussed in the last episode, data visualization can be very efficient when it comes to monitoring search traffic and recognizing spikes and slumps. Suppose you look at your dashboard one fine morning while drinking your coffee, and suddenly you find out that your Google search traffic dropped. What should you do? Luckily, you found this video. Today, I'll discuss the main reasons for organic traffic drops. This can help you go from the monitoring to the exploring mindset with a better assumption on what's happening. Then, I'll go through some tips to analyze your search traffic patterns and investigate overall trends in your industry. I've sketched a few examples of drops and what they could potentially mean. Let's start with the top left chart. Technical issues are errors that can prevent Google from crawling, indexing, or serving your pages to users. A site-level technical issue could be that your website is down. You'd see a significant drop in traffic in that case, not just from search. Manual actions happen when your website does not follow Google's guidelines. Some pages or the entire site may be less visible from Google search results through a manual action. In the bottom left chart, you'll see page-level technical issues. For example, an unintended no-index tag. Since this issue depends on Google crawling the page, it will be a slower drop in traffic than site-level issues. Also, Google is always improving how it evaluates content and updating its algorithm accordingly. For instance, core updates may change how some pages perform in Google search over time. Usually, this would not be a sharp decline. Another factor that could drive a slow decline in traffic is a search interest disruption. Sometimes changes in user behavior will change the demand for certain queries, either due to a new trend or a major change in the country you're looking at. This means your traffic may drop simply because of external influences. In the top right chart, you can see seasonality effects. Those may be caused by many reasons, such as weather, vacations, or holidays. They're usually repetitive and happen at specific regular intervals, such as weekly, monthly, or quarterly. In the bottom right chart, we can see reporting glitches. Usually, if you see a major change followed immediately by a return to the norm, it could be a simple glitch. We usually add chart annotations to let you know when it happens. The best way to understand what happened to your traffic is to look at your Search Console Performance Report, since it summarizes a lot of information. Analyzing the shape of the line will tell you a lot. Visit the Search Performance Report and try a few things. Expand the date range to include 16 months. This will help you analyze the traffic drop in context and make sure it's not a drop that happens regularly due to a holiday or a trend. To view more than 16 months of data, you could periodically export and store the data. Compare the drop period to a similar period, like the same month last year or the same day last week. This will help you find what exactly changed. Make sure to click all tabs to find out if the change happened only for specific queries, pages, countries, devices, or search appearances. Make sure you're comparing the same number of days, preferably the same days of the week. Analyze different search types separately. This will help you understand whether the drop was restricted to search, Google Images, video, or news tab. If there are major changes in your industry or country, people may start searching using different queries or using their devices for different purposes. In addition, if you sell a specific brand online, there might be a new competing product cannibalizing your search queries. To analyze general trends for web, image, news, shopping, and YouTube search, you can use Google Trends. which provides access to a largely unfiltered sample of actual search requests made to Google. You can also segment the data by country and category to make it more relevant to your website audience. Check the queries that are driving traffic to your website to see if they have clear drops in different times of the year. For example, food-related queries are very seasonal. People search for diets in January, turkey in November, and champagne in December. Different industries have different levels of seasonality. I've written about the subject in the past. Check out the links in the description to learn more about analyzing overall trends. Now you know how to build a monitoring dashboard and how to make an informed decision if you see a drop in your Google search traffic. That's a great start. In the next episode, we'll look into more ways to analyze your search performance using a bubble chart. Stay tuned.